I've waited all I can wait. It's time to do this thing. You hear that clinking? That's that lamp I took apart. I'm gonna powder coat it. I don't know, might be periwinkle blue, I'm not sure. But last summer, Sean took the TR4 out and he sort of declared that it was a little too squirrely in the back end. Well, that's the way they were. But I went to look up, I need to dedicate this to Wilber. Wilber was an employee at Lowe's, but a car guy, very old fellow, friend of Tommy's. So we'll dedicate this to Wilber because we talked about this and then he died about a month ago. So, but he was pretty sick. So here's this banker's lamp. It's a little cheaper than I assumed it was. I think that kind of proved it right there. It's just tin, but I'm going to fix it up anyway. But that's not the point of today's endeavor. I had to glue some shoes together. Every now and then you got to glue a shoe. This is the object of today's endeavor, is this Addco and these pieces here that go in honky. That's what I call it. Oops. Could have done better than that, huh? I don't think it's going to be too hard. So, is it just one piece of paper? I thought it was like two pieces of paper. So, direction 920. What is this thing? There's no sun up in the sky. Stormy weather. So, I got to move Daff and Gilda and all that other stuff. So, we're going to put this right here. It's kind of windy today. So, let's move Daff. And let's go. She's really a dusty, filthy mess, isn't she? And I've got the battery all charged up. And I'm going to clean the windscreen right now. And I've got to move this thing. I think I've got the software figured out on this thing. Windows 10, boy. I hadn't used Windows since I don't know when. 20 years. Boy, I told them, I'm not going to use that anymore. And Windows is working just about the way I remembered it. I always wondered why, if you ever got a computer with Windows on it, why didn't they send you some kind of revolver so you could blow your brains out? What a piece of junk. What junk that is. Apple's not much better these days. I'll just hang that. Let that hang there. So I'm going to check the oil, clean the glass, and get her over on the lift. So I got to move two other vehicles to move this vehicle. Let's go for a ride, too. And I do this just mostly to keep the birds off of her. I don't think that's going to be a problem there. So, yeah, I hadn't had her out in a while. Let's do her upright. What time is it? Ooh, 5 o'clock. I don't have long to. Okay, well, let's get this. It's an Addco roll bar. It's an Addco roll bar. I got it from Jegs. I think you can get them in various places. So I think she'll run fine. So let's get her out. Let's start moving stuff around. We might go for a little ride down the road. We got the glass clean. Let's see how long the fuel pump goes. Let's see how much gas I got. There she goes. You gotta listen for that. Okay, I got enough gas. I got the red light. Boy, that's her. And then, what is that down there? Main beams. What are the main beams doing on? How'd that happen? Oh, there you go, because I had them on. Okay, now, I'm not going to pull the choke. It's probably 50, 60 degrees. Let's see how long it takes to get oil pressed. Because she's been sitting for a couple of months, because I've been busy with other things. Okay. Okay, I feel like that's enough. Now, I put this locking choke thing in here. Okay.
There you go, see?
Whoa, listen to her purr.
See, it didn't take long. I gotta rev her up and make the ignition light go out. But let's let her stabilize a little bit before we do that. And what kind of voltage have I got?
Well, I'm showing, oh yeah, okay, it went up enough to knock it out. Yeah, she's 15 volts after that cranking episode I had to do. Look at that, the clock is about right. It's within 10 minutes, I'll be danged. Now, originally, I know a lot of you purists out there are gonna say there's supposed to be an amp meter here. What's with this thing? There you go. Well, I don't know what's wrong. There you go. Things are tricky. There's supposed to be an amp meter here, but I don't like amp meters. There it goes. All right. Whoa! I guess I need to check the tire pressure when I get her up there, too. So let's see if she moves here. I don't think the... There you go. Come on, baby. There we go. No big cracking noises or anything like that. All right, she's out in the sunlight. Well, that was pretty good. Now, she's squirrely in the back end, I'll give you that, and all that stuff. So let me take her up and down the road just a little bit, and we'll put her on the lift here in just a second, okay? Okay. A lot of y'all, ooh, gotta check the brakes too. A lot of y'all, see that phenomenon there? That it's like a little rainbow. What do you call that thing? I've always called them glories. I think that comes from a Scottish observation tower somewhere, like in the 19th century, but I don't know. Whatever that thing is, what do y'all call that? Just a little rainbow? So I've noticed it since I was small, and I just heard a glory one time, that's always stuck with me. Well, not too much of a problem, a little bit though. I was going, I only went about 4 or 5 miles. A little funny smell, engine seemed to be kind of dying, and well, here we are, oh no. And my brakes are kind of sticky, and I had to pull over and go back and forth and let them fan's going good. It would be after all the load it's been under. But yeah, she's brakes are kind of, that's what happens when you let them sit too long. Yes, I'm not even putting the brakes on and she's stopping. Now this car doesn't tend to run on, but I'm not going to risk it. There we go. And okay, handbrake on. And so we were having a little trouble there, but I think we're okay. All right, let's take her up. Are we rolling tape? Yeah, let's see which one it is. Well, there's the bonnet. Is it this one sticky? Ooh, I don't know. Ooh, that's pretty bad. That one's, I don't know what the drums are gonna look like. I don't think, well, I think they're all kind of sticky. 128. These take, I can smell them. Yeah, that ain't good. I'm gonna have to nurse this thing along here a little bit. I'm gonna stay with her. What they're designed to do is get hot, but see, that ain't so bad. 100-something degrees. It looks worse because it's so red. Well, I don't know what I think just need to drive it judiciously and see how it does, but yep, 400, sheesh, I can't have that. And then once it's like, you know, it's like any heat thing. Once it starts heating up, it just gets worse and worse and worse. So, yeah, it's 45 degrees. There it is. Okay, well, let's start up this and take her up and then put this here and this here. Okay. Okay, safety last. There you go. Make sure those are in the fronts and the backs. Take the ramps off. Let's pull the battery. That's going to help cool the whole thing off. I've gotten where I just don't leave the batteries connected much anymore. So you're wondering how I'm getting that with one hand, huh? Well, using my head. All right, so all right, let's take her up. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I think that's going to be okay, so let's let her make sure we're okay. Okay, we're okay. Give her a little bit of pressure. So, I'm not going to bring the flare down here and look at them brake things. Let's take off. This is my good hat. So, I'll try not to look like a boll weevil, even when I have to. I haven't been under this car in minutes. Okay, seems like I was just under here. And not much oil leaking, that's good. Let's just see. Those are the original calipers. Okay. Well, I think they can take it. I don't know what that is right there. It's melted the grease a little bit, maybe. Maybe that's all it was. And, okay. Might have to go up a little bit more. So here's the Remy Brothers exhaust system. That's why it sounds so nice. So, I think this, you think I ought to go up another one? Powder coating's nice, ain't it? See our magnet right there and all that other stuff. I think I might go up one more click. And there's my SU pump that you're not supposed to really have in this car, but it's just makes them a lot easier to start. Okay, let me go up one more click and then we'll bring it over here and look at things. Okay, now the one thing I don't want to forget to do is put these in, and I understand Pandora's not so, or what is it, YouTube ain't so bad about messing with people. I have a little background music on, so I don't have to test that theory. Remember, I got hacked, and so if you hadn't subscribed, be sure and subscribe and help me back to where I once was there. Well, I lost a lot of good footage. Okay, well, here's the bar. And let's just sort of survey this thing. And I'll give you the bird's eye lowdown on this pretty soon. So I think it goes on this way because of the hump for the exhaust system. So I'm glad there was a racing exhaust system on this dual pipe thing. And it wasn't that much, but I'm glad it's gone, and it's been happily recycled. So let's get the paper and see about this thing. Now there those are, and dang it, they don't seem pretty good. Those bumpers there. Well, I may not have to change those. I need to get my good flashlight down here, don't I? Those are a little different. They're on there with the... They got those wire things. I can do that. Well, I don't know. What's that one look like? Is it okay? Yeah, I'd say that's okay. I don't see any reason in messing with them. I'm glad I have them. They're just fine. Those bumpers are fine. I'm not going to mess with those. All right, so all you do here, if you're wondering, you just cut them wires and they just slip over. What do you think? You think I ought to do it? They feel very supple, and it is, I don't know, what are the tops like? Well, yeah, that's pretty supple, and yeah, I think that's just dandy. All right, so anyway, another little trick I show now and then. You got an SU pump, you got any kind of line for fuel or air vapor, put a little bit of
Scotch-Brite in there, keep the spiders and mud daubers out. I think I'm going to let these go. They weren't expensive. I just wanted to make sure I had them while I was under here. Don't need them. I had to, I think my camera angles are fouled up. I had to augment the hardware around this place with some NINs. I always keep a bunch of those in stock, and some flat washers and stuff. So what you do is you take out this and check these while you're around here, and take this one off and that one off, and you slip it through the best you can around that muffler. And for mine, you say muffins. And so there's, I'm gonna need two hands to do it, but I'll show you what it looks like in a minute. Okay, well, let's just put it up there. Okay, I lubricated this with some good silicone. I just put these in. What are you doing to me? I just put these in just sort of gently. And then you gotta assemble all this. I didn't mention that. A bunch of silicone in here. I've got my 680 Loctite. And this'll line you up here. Now then you gotta ask yourself a question. Do you wanna go inside the frame? And I think my answer to that would be yes. This lip is not enough. And this is gonna be kind of a high stress item. Make sure that you're in the middle, because see, there's a wall right here and there's a wall right there. So you want to go right in the middle of that sucker. And so, I think you can kind of meatball that to a certain degree. And so there we go. And so these things bottom out, so you don't have to worry about that. Just get them tight and they'll be fine. Those things kind of want to move around on you a little bit. I don't know what to do about that. I think I'm just going to try to whack that thing over a little tiny bit and then get a dead blower. So I'll just go get one. And then you can sort of adjust that and get that where you want it. And then there's the dead blow. And so it looks like you could hit right here if you weren't careful. And that's what's going on over here. So there we go, it moved a little bit. Yeah, so try to get them angles as close as you can. That's gonna throw all your geometry off there, it's okay. So, all right, I'm gonna need both hands for this. And then this'll be your marker. And you know what to do there. You wanna get this as close to you can, so there's your white out. Now, I'm going to drill these holes according to what this says. I don't care what the directions say. I'm gonna try to make this as tight as I can. So we're gonna put it in frac. And so we're at zero in frac. And this is probably, what, 3/8? Do you think it's 3/8? Five sixteenths. So I missed that one. 21/64. Let's start with a 5/16. And if we need to go up from there, we will. Yeah, 3/8 would have been much bigger. I think I don't know. But all right. So these have got to go up and in there. Let's just see how this reads. Okay. Well. It says drill with a 3/8 drill bit. We're gonna try to. Okay, we'll go to 21/64 and see. I don't want to go to 3/8. It's kind of making me nervy, because I mean you don't want this hole to be too big. I mean you're gonna be grabbing a big part of the frame, but anyway, you know how it is. I just don't want to do that. Just don't feel like it. So let's get this straightened out. These tightened up. And then I'll go for drilling them holes. I've just got a call. I may have to go in. I may have to put this off till tomorrow. Okay, but I don't know yet. I've got a tiger by the tail. All right, good old Buck Owens. All right, so we've got those marked. just go, and that one's getting a little crusty. All right, I don't see any reason. See, there you go. And there are your marks, and there are your marks. I got put some silicone here and inside the thing. And then I got all this stuff tight, this tight, everything's tight. So all I gotta do now is drill holes, but I don't think I'm gonna do this right now. So let's wait till tomorrow. Just wasn't thinking. So let's remeasure this thing here. So I needed to measure it at the three-eighths, not at the other point. So it is 3/8. Okay, it is 3/8, so I was right. But I did look through the instructions, but I promise you I didn't look at that. I thought 5/7. Let's just go get a 3/8 drill bit and drill. And I've got like a 30-minute reprieve here. Don't think I can finish this tonight, but I'm going to try. Okay, I don't know what you can see. You can see that, okay. I got the... I had this old button kind of drill bit with a little tip on it, man. That cut through that, like, you can't see it, but it's that brad, there you go, that brad kind of bit. Come on, baby. Okay, so it just don't want to focus. But anyway, it's one of them. I got to do it now. There you go. I wonder why it works like that. But that thing just sliced right through it. The thing there. So let's see if these go through. So the thing here is you're supposed to go up and in like that, and then you're supposed to be able to turn it over, and then you're supposed to come down on the other side, and you don't want to lose it up in there, so you kind of want to keep your bacon from burning here. I don't want to go because it's at that funky angle. This can be sort of a hit and miss proposition. Let's try it at this angle. This means I gotta change hands here. Y'all, hang with me now. Let's see if I can get this thing to pop through. And I've done this a couple of times. I did this on the Spitfire, and I kind of remember this quandary. So don't go whacking that thing with a hammer. If you pop it up in there, you're going to be sad. You don't want to be sad. Now, I ain't going to weeble wobble that nice drill bit around, so I'm going to enlarge this just a little tiny bit, and this one here and this one here, just a little tiny bit. Let's go get the right drill bit and just incrementally do this until we get her to slip through. This is one of the things you run into when you're trying to do this kind of framework. With Spitfire, made such a difference on Spitfire. I hope it makes the same difference on TR4. Dadgummit, let's just see if one of these is working. I hate when I get doing something I want to do that's fun and then I feel kind of stressed and all that other stuff because... So, how do you turn this thing on? I don't remember. There you go. Okay. All right. So, what I did was... Oh, that's that light. That ain't no good for me. I went to 25/64. All right. There we go. That's better. I went to 25/64, and I think the thing to do is just try it this way first. See if that gets that thread to go up in there. So 25/64 is about the smallest increment I could. It is the next. Well, I'm sure there's more. Nope, that ain't gonna do. And if those threads don't go up in there, you can't get that to dance over enough to work. Okay, well let's try. All right, this is always like. Always like this. Okay, it got kind of ugly because I made a mistake. I should have, you can see I had to kind of drill a little bit more down, because I should have measured off this and not that bracket right there. I should have measured off that, but it's okay. I might just go ahead. I'll just tack weld that up when I get around there anyway. That's probably one of those situations where you think, oh, I made a mistake, and then you think, well, maybe I didn't. This probably, to me, would be a more of a weld-on thing anyway. So I may just drag her over and do that tomorrow. I got metal shavings all down myself. Okay, well, let's get this thing bolted up anyway. It's nothing terrible. It's just plenty of steel. It took me a while to drill through the stuff because this frame is so good. So I'm not afraid of that. Just a little tack welding here, I think, is a good idea. All right, this is definitely it. I'm gonna have to test drive tomorrow. So I got them all in. Looks pretty good. Just imagine me going zzzz with a welder there. And then the next thing you see will be me driving around. The only other thing I think that might be a problem is you might get a rattle where that is. I don't think so. I mean, it's possible. Yeah, I guess I could tighten them up a little. They got loose, didn't they? Okay, well, let me tighten them up too. So just tighten everything up. Just go around a couple times, tighten everything up, and we will. You know, the one thing I didn't look at, let's see, I put that there to remind me to check the air pressure tomorrow. I'm a little worried about the brakes sticking. Look at that. That baby's been sitting there for months, and that's all I got on the floor on a TR4. 58-year-old car or something like that. I'll take that. Okay. Let's go for a ride, okay? Well, I promised Tommy I would talk about Wilber a little bit more, so I will. So, Wilber, this is what we're talking about. I don't know if I showed the front of this car, but this is a TR4. And there's lots of reasons you can tell it's not a TR4A or TR250, but you can look those up if you want to. It doesn't have the side markers, and the grills are different and stuff like that. Nomenclature's a little different on the bonnet. I am going to pull these front wheels off, and I got to slide that thing in, I forgot, and jack up the front end and see about why the brakes are like they are. May have to exercise those manually. But a little bit of a walk around here. I hope this is going to work well. I don't know why it wouldn't. So you latch it in here, got that going. This tightens up only so far. Put your lubricant in there. This kind of bit me a little bit, but not bad enough to worry about. I got to drag the welder over here and do a little spot welding. And I was thinking about sawing these off. I don't see any reason in that. I may not, I don't know. They are, look at that. It's like the Healy. You're only, you know, 3 fingers from the road there, but I don't know. We'll see. It does kind of hang down a lot. But just general overall, I had a friend who somebody welded a trailer hitch back here. Oh, good. Okay, TR4 hauling a trailer. All right, great. Let's not do that. So I got my exhaust system wrapped. Oh, there went the ultrasonic getting turned off. This is your handbrake. I guess I need to let that off and make sure that's not dragging. So if you ever see these diagrams, you'll see it doesn't really mention a spring right there, but you do need one. These are interesting cars. See this rubber plug? This goes up into the floorboard. When you jack this car up, you're supposed to jack it from inside the car. And I have the jack, and it hooks in right here. I remember demonstrating this at the Roadster factory for the Boy Scouts one time. But look what a great condition that's in, and this side too. And so there that is. And she didn't leak hardly any, so good. Now, my limited understanding of TR4s, which is not limited in almost any way, is that this was somewhat of a factory option to have a front torsion bar. Wilber mentioned that it needed to be a certain diameter. I don't remember what he said,
but I'm curious to see what we got here. I don't think that I would replace that because it is an original stand part and a standard Rover Triumph. Let's see what that is just for fun. So 11/16, that's plenty. That's plenty big. I forgot what this one was. And this one is, let's just kind of, I'll usually have to bounce one, 5/8. Better than nothing. The Spitfire came with one in the front. I put one in the back. I had to, well, that was a big McGill. I wish I'd recorded that a long time ago. Because since that's independent rear on Spitfire, things are a little different. You end up trying to have to pull the car down to get everything to hook up. So that's going to complete this. We'll go on a test drive here in a minute, and I feel like this is going to help a lot. This is the semi-elliptical leaf spring. I did rebuild these. You can see the new bolts up in there, new nuts and bolts, the shackle arrangement. If you've ever wondered why it works the way it does, you got a straight bolt in the front, and as you go toward the back, you got a double thing so the system can you know, flex as it should. That's true of a Ford truck or whatever. It's all the same. So I think everything looks pretty good here. The overdrive in this car works great. That's going to be a next project there. And so we got that going here. So that's doing good. And I don't really have much else to say about it. This is the originally, if you're kind of interested in any other history now that I'm done, you might wonder what that hole is in the grill right there. Well, that's where you put your hand crank. Yep. Yes, team, that is true. yep, that's where you put your hand crank on a 1964 vehicle. It's just a holdover. So this is the original type grill, and you can tell it got a little bad time there one time. But they had holes in the radiator right here for that to pass through and go on to a fancy bolt that went there that I replaced, because I took all that 5 pounds of stuff off that held the original pan, and it's generally always out of balance. So I just did it that way, and I put on a real nice spell electric fan. And you'll also find the original cowling air duct won't fit worth a flip. So you have to sort of get it to where it tucks in and actually puts the air through the radiator. So I told Tommy I'd do a walkthrough on the count of Wilber. So you can tell there was some work done here. Their pop rivets weren't factory equipment, but that's just the outer seal plates, the seal stand rocker panels. Can be a problem, and so it doesn't look too bad. And I painted it gray a couple years ago. So let's I'm gonna let her about halfway down. Let me set my jack up and get this front end up in there so I can look at this thing. Now the other interesting thing about these cars too is the front shocks are telescoping shocks. They're inside the spring right there. They're your kind of normal, what one would call normal shocks, tubular shocks. And I'm going to go ahead and say this now. I think I'm old enough to share this with you. These are the Armstrong lever shocks up in there. They're like, I wish I could get a better picture of that, but I can't. But you can look them up. You know, Armstrong levers are, there it is right there. And it has little tubes in an arm. And the arm hooks to a link on the top of the leaf springs right here. There's the blue arm right there, and there's the one over here. Those are original parts. Now, gang, you can spend a lot of time and a lot of money getting the special oils and all that other stuff. And when you open, if you open these up, it's going to smell like rotten fish most of the time. They've never been worked on. I mean, they're bad. I think in the early days they were made by Lockheed, but these are made by Armstrong. And I fill them up with contact cement. Okay, I said it. I finally said it. That came to me in a dream when I was like 19 on an MGB that had busted shocks, and the MGB shocks are part of the upper A arm, and they're like $400 a piece.
And one Saturday morning, I jumped up. I said, Eureka. It was my Archimedes moment or Pythagoras or whoever the hell it was. And I went out and I bought a little can of contact cement and I drained all the oil that was already drained because they leaked so badly. There was like no oil in either shock on the front of this 1967 MGB I had. I filled it with contact cement, and when it leaked out, it just cured up and stopped leaking. And I just flushed everything out, filled them up with contact cement, and never had another problem. And every time I get a car like this, I take these off, and not very hard to do, and take them apart, clean them up, put everything back together, and just work some good 8001. Usually I buy it in a can, but you know, 8008, 8001, some kind of, you can just use cheap contact cement and fill them with contact cement and you'll be fine. And it don't cost that much. But I talked to these guys in car shows and stuff, used to, and they would spend an inordinate amount of time on those. So, okay, so I know, let's skip on. I know that I said I was going to do one thing, but this is, I generally do multiple things on my videos. And I do appreciate y'all watching and liking and subscribing. So let's drop her down, look at the front brakes, and then take her for a test drive, okay? Well, this will be a later video, but what I did was I jacked up the car, front end of the car, and I spun the wheels. They spun just beautifully, and I went and applied the brakes, and then I came out, and they were basically locked. So that'll be a future video, but there are two different size rotors. There's 11 and like, it's 10 and a half or 10 and three quarters. I can't remember. What do the boots look like here? Yeah, there's that shock I was telling you about. And I did those recently. And there's my alternator. That was a good video too. Yeah, you always got to check those. These are the easy kind to fix. The earlier kind were not as good. So, What I did was, and you got to measure the rotors to get the right pads and whatnot. So I did it with my valve compression tool. I thought that was a pretty good idea. So mine are, I'd say 11s. Well, they're certainly not 10 and a half. The real way to do it would be take them down, but you got all this hub stuff in the way. Let's look at this again and see if I can try not to sky the car. So down there and up there. So it's at the uppermost of that mark I made. So I think these are 11, so I'm gonna have to rebuild these calipers or something. Yeah, I'm going to call those 11s. I guess that's what they are. So this is a little bit later TR4. I've got the VIN number up there if I need it, but I don't think they go by that very often. Well, CT, whatever it is, I'll figure it out. Okay, we are going to crank her up here and take her on a very brief trip. There goes oil pressure. And I mean very brief. Ooh, she ain't digging that, is she? There we go. Okay. And I'll talk about it on the road, and then we're going to put a name in on this, and because I'm gonna have to rebuild those calipers. There's just no other way around it. And so I've got the stainless steel lines and stainless steel pistons and all, so I'm just gonna kind of give her a little back and forth on the road, and I'll let you know how it goes. I can tell you, just going down the driveway, it's better. It's very better. It's very different. It feels like the Spitfire a little bit more. Whoa. Tell you what, let's let me get through the gears here. tried to hit the brakes any, but wow, what stability. I mean, that is so different. Well, I gotta give that a definite thumbs up. I hope you give me one. And I'm gonna turn in right here, so I'll have a summation in just a second. Alright, that's it. I mean, that I should have done that a long time ago. I can't believe this was rigged up for a race car and they didn't do that, but they didn't. I am literally amazed at how much better it is. Sean was exactly right. So let me pull in and say goodnight, and thumbs up, subscribe, and we will talk later.